Mr. Riley, before I welcome back to San Fernando, she moves to San Fernando, and we are actually, I was at the last concert in that Ringham Hall many, many moons ago. I'm very happy to refer to her as an international star and a San Fernandian. I know we San Fernandians are very proud and clannish. So welcome back, Sherma, and tell us what Sherma achievement, what you've been doing in recent days.
Well, before I can tell you about Sherma's achievement, Sherma had me a little confused with life a bit, because I thought Trinidad was San Fernando, because all she would talk about is San Fernando all her life. We had to pry out her hand to figure out that she is from Trinidad, that Trinidad, San Fernando is in Trinidad. So she has really flying the flag of San Fernando with everything she has throughout her career, throughout her school, throughout her tenure. And Shaman, who is to tell you about her, she is a daughter of the soil of Trinidad and Tobago from San Fernando, as the Honorable Mayor said. She started off her journey at 4 years of age, where she started, you know, playing and singing. And she moved on quickly to become a three-time holder of the Junior College Sumana. From there, she moved on to get the first National Youth Award in Culture in Trinidad and Tobago. Then she moved to the Caribbean Song Festival winner, maybe the youngest person to win the Caribbean Song Festival. Then she moved on to a scholarship at Berklee School of Music, where she topped with honors, and she's known to be the trailblazer in Berklee. Everybody wanted to meet Sherma Andrews. So she pioneered the name San Fernando in Berklee School of Music. And all, you know, the other day I was speaking to Christopher Tambo Hubbard, and he said everybody wanted to meet Sherma Andrews. She was the one to meet in school, in college, in university. Sherma then moved on, after talking with honors, to continue to proceed with her career and develop two opportunities. She got an opportunity to tour Europe and the USA with some of the big acts in the world, like Iglesias and Britney Spears. Sherma was the one when Whitney Houston was challenged in life that she could not go on tour. Sherma was the one chosen out of this world to perform that duty, to fulfill that space, that she would act on behalf of Whitney Houston on tour. Sherma continued to pioneer her music, and she opened a show called The Legendary Lady Singers, which has done her really, really proud, because she has been engaged in many concert halls throughout the United States of America. And with that, Sherma has decided to launch a new album, with her first single being launched very, very soon.
Where is she launching that soon?
What's that?
Where is she launching that?
Well, that album is going to be launched with a single, and that single will be launched on San Fernando Hill.
Wow.
Jesus.
Yay!
So, you know, having said that, and I mean, then they're just part of our bio. Let me just see this at last year. For our city celebration last year, which runs for a year, the San Fernando City Corporation declared that year, that period from November last year to November this year, as the year of the arts. And it is fitting that this is happening within the year of the arts. So I want to congratulate you on your remarkable achievement. I want to just outline it to be sitting in for Whitney Houston. You can't get better than that. And to be outstanding in Berklee, again, it says about your talent, your gift. And again, once more, leadership at the San Fernando, we are so proud of you. We're so happy to have you here. And continue to fly the flag of Trinidad Tobago in going up and out there as you are there. So congratulations.
Thank you.
And we wish you all the success in going forward. And I know you're going to do extremely well. I'm looking forward to the launch of the record in San Fernando Hill.
Yeah.
And you're going to the peak, to the top.
Yeah.
That's your Mount Everest for all of us. So congratulations. And if you want to share your thoughts with us, what this journey has been like for you, what you're able to do, and how you feel. How you're thinking back home as well.
Oh, well, Ms. Mayor, I'm so happy to be home. I know it's a very sad time for the nation, you know, as we suffer through this pandemic. It's a sad time for our, you know, for just being, you know, being someone that's living in this world right now. like about being home. It doesn't matter if we're suffering. You're still seeing the smiles. You're still feeling the warmth. You know, it's something that we, especially in San Fernando, we have that togetherness. And we help each other. And that is a beautiful thing. I feel like what I want to do, I want to contribute to that. So as a result of this pandemic and how it's hurt my people and how it continues to hurt my people, I feel it's important to do something about it. So I'm trying to donate some masks to some of the homes to see if I can, you know, help. And so we're working on that with the concert. Also, my journey in general, based on your question, Mayor, has been one that is really teaching. I believe that it's important for us to see things, not just how we see it, but be open to other people's experiences and their highs and their lows. Because when you see what other people are experiencing, you can realize that not just what's happening to you is important. What's happening to someone else is just as important. And so with that realization that we're all important and we're all together in this, it's very important for us to, it offers growth. So the growth as a person.
It is so noble of you to see from that perspective. Particularly somebody that moved so far in life, but sometimes people reach, don't remember where they came. So it's always important to give back and to give back. So that will be appreciated. And we have the media here with us this morning. I know if Mr. Webb from the news, they would like to ask that question.
Tell us what you would have done at Berkeley. Oh, in Berkeley,
I had such a fun time. I met a lot of people there. It was a dream come true. I did arranging, which is the ability to write for various instruments. So I can write for an orchestra or a small band or anything. Mm-hmm. And I remember having just eating a sandwich, just minding my business, and this entourage of this guy came coming up to me and said, "Are you the infamous Sherma Andrews?" Mm-hmm. I've heard about you. That was so fun. To know that I was just doing what I had to do, and that was really touching people, whether it's negative, positive, whatever, it was actually causing a stir. And I was just happy to be a Trinidadian causing a stir.
Having an impact.
Yes.
What it was like to sit in for Whitney Houston? Tell us about that.
Well, that was also a major honor because Whitney Houston, she had a beautiful gift, an artistic talent that was just totally beyond most singers.
But it was a period when she couldn't make the heights, so
yes.
Maybe two. So that's what you were doing for her?
Yes, what happened, she just couldn't, that particular tour, she couldn't tour. I don't know if it was just the illness or what have you, everything was on the...
We saw her in Tobago Jazz Festival in 2009, I think it was.
Mm-hmm.
And she did some of those songs, she just couldn't, back those things have to help her along.
Yes, it's very, very tragic when that happens. And it happens to a lot of great singers, and it's usually because of a lot of nights that are used just ignoring what you have to do for your voice. You know, not
for you to
hurt.
Be selected to make the film that speaks volumes for your talent, and especially
you.
In America, as a Trinidadian piece, that can that speak volumes for us?
Tell us how that
came about. How it came about?
Yeah.
I was touring with Enrique Iglesias,
mm-hmm.
and he had sang the number one song with her at that time, Could I Have This Kiss Forever? And so she couldn't make it on the tour. So he would introduce me and he would say to the audience, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry, but I have good news and bad news. The bad news is that Whitney Houston cannot perform tonight. And then he would say, and so the audience would go, oh. But the good news is that Sherma Andrews is here, and she's going to sing just as good as Whitney Houston, which was like, he's putting me on the spot. So I had to give it my all, and I did, and we had a great time.
What kind of reviews would you have gotten for that concert?
I didn't hear.
What kind of reviews you would have gotten?
Oh, the reviews were great. I mean, I was very, very humbled and happy to know that the reviews, everybody was just really happy with my performance. So.
Did it open new doors for you?
Yes, every performance, every person you meet, yes, absolutely. I was able to work with some of the greatest musicians after that, you know, hearing and knowing that I'm capable of doing, you know, doing well in my field.
Mm-hmm.
It absolutely did, yes.
So is your base, where are you based now?
Well, that's an easy mm-hmm. one. Home is where the heart is. So my base will always be here,
mm-hmm.
always be home.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I travel. Yes, I, you know, go all over the place. But especially with the launch of my new album,
mm-hmm.
I want to launch my album here in San Fernando, and I want to work with a lot of people from the Caribbean who are excelling over and over and just need that recognition. So we need to pull together
mm-hmm.
and create a, you know, a world, hey, we're here. The Caribbean is here,
mm-hmm.
Trinidad is here,
mm-hmm.
San Fernando is here.
What sort of genre are we looking at?
The genre mm-hmm. is R&B pop with, of course, a soca feeling.
Mm-hmm.
So that taste
mm-hmm.
is going to be my, you know, my little mixture.
You're the only vocalist?
Yes.
You're the only vocalist?
You mean, well, I'm launching myself as an artist, yes.
Mm-hmm. What about instruments? Do you play, what instruments do you play?
I started with the accordion, then I played, that was 4.5 years old, I know it. Mom bought it as a present for Christmas,
mm-hmm.
and something happened, I knew what to do.
Mm-hmm.
When I was 7, I played the organ,
mm-hmm.
and ever since, I've been a keyboardist, so I play piano.
What about the fun?
I play a little, I play Doremi and the Pan. That's about it.
is that
Before, when she spoke about the instruments, I was saying, so when are you going to do a banner of a duty?
Yeah.
So, I'm one of those, right? Just to let you know, when it comes to the Pan,
mm-hmm.
I have to sit down and listen. I can't do, no.
Mm-hmm.
I have to, because it's so amazing,
mm-hmm.
I just love to, and I'm an arranger. So look out for me. Hopefully I can do some pan arrangements.
There you go.
Is the pan influence, has the pan influenced any of your songs on this album?
Oh, the pan, yes. In fact, I intend to, one of my greatest friends is Darren Shepherd.
Okay.
And I know
and end up in Fun Player.
That's not a competition.
And
San Fernando, promoting San Fernando.
Yes.
Yeah.
And my dear friend who passed, Ken Professor Clomore.
Oh boy.
Boy, I grieved because I wasn't able to say hi. That was very difficult for me.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like I, you know, so sad.
Mm-hmm.
But what a legacy he left, thank God.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, I intend to use pan in some of my songs. Yes.
Are you a writer as well?
Songwriter, yes.
Some
mm-hmm.
have they been written by you, or what you collaborated with?
You mean the song?
On your album.
Yes. The songs are primarily written by me, myself,
mm-hmm.
and you wouldn't believe it, but my manager
mm-hmm.
is actually a good songwriter himself, so we collaborated on one song,
mm-hmm.
and he was part of a group that he led to number 3 on the UK charts,
mm-hmm.
that a group that was actually from Trinidad,
mm-hmm.
New Creation. I'm sure you've heard of them.
Was that in June?
Yes.
I was in London. I was in London when they came to London.
Oh, wow.
What year was this?
early 1990s, of course.
More in the late 90s. But it's about 15, 20 years
So.
I was in London when I saw on the papers the group from Trinidad coming in and they had done something like a cover of In June.
Yeah.
A lot of writers. Wow, I had to go and see this group. I didn't know who they were reading about them. So I went to a press conference and I was there looking at these guys. Mm-hmm. A long time ago.
So what do you sing, soprano or libretto? And what voice?
I'm a mezzo soprano. So I'm not a high soprano, I'm the mezzo, but just under the high soprano.
Mm-hmm. Suma, you've done it all. You've been there. What, in your opinion, is your cutting edge?
My cutting edge. Maybe my heart. Because I guard my heart with my God. And I do believe that as long as I keep myself humble and loving, I think that will always guide my every move, my every motivation, my every style, So that is what I believe is my cutting edge. My heart.
I think I have a different perspective. Most artists expect a band, an orchestra, to accompany them. You play for yourself and you accompany yourself. This is how I see it.
Oh. I appreciate that, and I think it's a very important thing to do, to be self-sufficient.
Yeah.
Yes, I appreciate that. Mm-hmm. And it's something that I love doing because it's just an expression that has developed inside of me as a result of years of wanting to do it. I would hear it on the radio. I would hear all these great songs on the radio, and I just wanted to do it. Like, mm-hmm. I wanted to play that. Mm-hmm. So that was my motivation. I had an ear for music. No one taught me. It just happened. So that's why I'm so in tune with the Holy Spirit. I do believe in God. I believe that God gave me this talent. Mm-hmm. And because how could you explain that all of a sudden I know these chords, I just don't know the names. But I know what they sound like, I know how to reproduce them. I was playing the organ in church at age 7.
Mm.
You know, my feet couldn't even reach the pedals in the bottom. But I'm playing.
With church?
That was at Marbella RC. And so I'm convinced that God is real. And he's real in my heart. And
you have been chosen.
And I have been chosen to do good things.
So gospel is also part of your repertoire?
Yes, absolutely. Mm-hmm. I do believe that sometimes the gospel industry is not very inviting.
Mm-hmm.
They don't accommodate all people. Mm-hmm. This is just the way I feel. I feel that if we look at Jesus and how Jesus lived, Jesus was among everyone. So I really don't like that kind of like, oh, I'm gospel. No.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I tend to be more like
All inclusive,
exactly.
In your school, Pleasantville Senior, you have siblings who are also involved in the arts. Where are they now?
Like my classmates?
Blood brothers.
Oh, my siblings. Oh, yeah. Well, my brother, Edward,
mm-hmm.
singer extraordinaire, when he opened his mouth, he'd be like, oh, you sure it was James Ingram or,
Mm.
And he went on to do medicine.
Okay.
So he's a surgeon, orthopedic surgeon. And he is in London. Larry unfortunately passed. There was a drunk driver that took his life in 2000. And he was a great guitar player. So, and then Sandra did some guitar and what have you. But I guess they all have it. And their young ones kept the music alive a little bit too. But I the only one who decided to brave and make it a career.
Can you tell us a little more about the album and what's the inspiration behind the album?
Thank you. Well, first of all, I wanted to create an album that is truly my heart. And home is where the heart is. So this album that I'm working on, like I said earlier, I'm going to create this album based on working and interacting with other people from Trinidad or from the Caribbean, or you know, and the inspiration for my album is just that reminiscing feeling. Like whenever I went away and I traveled all over the world, but there was nothing like that feeling when I came home. And to when I, you know, I had a nice little alarm clock thing going with it, the birds that would wake me up in the morning in Trinidad, and you never get that anywhere else. You know, that feeling, and yeah, I'm having doubles for breakfast, you know, and just the whole roti and the palau, and I don't know, I just love home, I love my people, I love their smiles. Just happy, yes. So the nostalgia was really what sort of propelled the album, and the fact that I wanted to make everyone know that you can have a great career with God in it, and you don't have to be, you know, gospel. You can actually include everyone in your search for goodness and God.
So you visited now, or you've come home to stay, or what's happening for
well,
a while? Or what's
I'm here for a while, and like I said, even though it seems like I'm visiting, I always feel like I'm here, I'm home. Yeah, sure.
I've been trying to bring you my got the exemption, and Sherma got in that flight. Sherma so wanted to come back home that she actually reached the airport with her suitcase in her hand and didn't get on the flight. However, we kept trying and would not give up. So we eventually got the exemption and everything in place. And when she got here, then the government of Trinidad and Tobago had to change the policy, because the pandemic, the virus was getting out of hand. So when we got the exemption, all the halls were still open. There was a performance called for Napa, Port of Spain, Napa, Rima, Goa, South, and the cultural complex in Tobago. It seemed all impossible because now we can't have this show. But Sherma and myself were very determined. It wasn't only about a show for Mother's Day to bless the mothers of Trinidad and Tobago and the Caribbean, but it was an opportunity to share and to give love. So we decided, because we are working on the first album at present, the producers out of Canada, and we would spend some time here in Trinidad and Tobago to find some of the top contributors in this music industry in the world. In the world, man, some of them are writing to that right now, stuck in this pandemic. So we decided to take the opportunity to work with people like Stephen Taylor, who has worked with, you know, productions with Will Smith, and you would find more of Stephen Taylor as you get a name. We're also working with someone from San Fernando, who is a young producer, who is in a writer's guild internationally, who have worked with Grammy Productions, is right here in Trinidad at present. So what we decided, was
can
that?
Can we get a name?
Mark Dinwell.
What's that?
Mark Dingwall.
Mark Dingwall. That's the attorney's brother. The saxophone. Yeah.
Right. Michael Dingwall.
So
Michael Dingwall.
I don't know.
Well, this gentleman came highly recommended by Christopher Tambo Glover himself. And when we were looking to allow Trinidad to be as much a part of this production that we can, we had to search deep and wide to find the right contributors with the capacity that could deliver at an international level. Because Christopher Tambo Hilbert was in Berkeley at the same period with Sherma, he was not only an artist, an experienced singer, but also a qualified one. He was the one I seek to get a direction of pointing who has the capacity to deliver the takes for Sherma's voice, because if that is not done well, then it's not going to happen. So Mr. Mark Dingwall was highly recommended to do the job. Along other, you know, the video is going to be done here in Trinidad. San Fernando Hill is going to be a very major part of this video. I could give a little peek, the pitch day is going to be involved. Many years ago, when I managed New Creation, one of the things that I did is that the label, I negotiated for them to fly a film crew to Trinidad and Tobago. It was the first time ever a music video was done on film in Trinidad. And we flew to Tobago and we did all the sites. So that Hey Jude was a marketing tool for Trinidad and Tobago as we rose to number three in London, France, Germany. Everybody saw Tobago, everybody. So I'm using the same direction to allow Sherma, because of her love for San Fernando, to take the country to the world through her gift and her talents. And this is the focus. And it's like God, you know, made it in heaven right now. The pandemic is not an opportunity. It's a great challenge, but in challenges there are opportunities, and we must focus on the opportunities. The vineyard is hefty with fruits right now. A lot of fruits out there, but people is afraid to go in the vineyard because of the COVID. But if you try drive your vehicle through there, it will be overflowing with fruits because the fruits are many. So we are using technology, we are using the medium of faith through a power greater than us called God. And I will speak this to the country, to the Caribbean, and to the world. Our goal is 9 platinum golden Grammy hits. And I know people are starting to say, what is wrong with this man? But when I told them that I would rock London at number one, they thought I was crazy, with a young group called New Creation who could sing in their mind proper English or speak proper English, and they had no diction and they didn't have this. So I listened to them, and every challenge was an opportunity for me to develop these guys. And these young men rose to the cause, rocked London at number three and toured Europe. Sherma's gifts, talents, knowledge, and understanding, and discipline will take us straight to the top in Jesus' name. Yes? So we're going to walk by faith. We seek the support of the country, of the people. The past is we see when artists or sports people are on that journey, nobody wants to come out and support. But when they rise to the top, they rally. I'm saying that Sherma has come back here. She didn't have to come here. She could have done this totally outside of Trinidad and Tobago. But we would see the benefits of it. Sherma is here also to do a master class. Sherma to give that opportunity for younger ones to understand that they too could excel. And one of the things that is important Sherma is focusing on, she's willing to stretch her hand and pull some up, and not to step on them, but to pull them up and create an opportunity for others to excel. She must focus, she has a passion to give back. So she's looking at the less fortunate, the homes, these children's homes, to give them masks, because there's a challenge. Everybody's mask is like that. And the reason they say that is because they cannot breathe, they cannot speak, it's not audible. So there's this product that Sherma found out about, and she's decided she would invest in this opportunity to raise funds through her concert, through donations, to give at least 1,900 to 1,000 masks to those people, those children who nobody's thinking about. They need to live, they need to survive, yes? And so that's one of the costs we're working on. So this opportunity here is one where it's very challenging. It's very challenging because the concert, there's no longer an income to the tickets, right? Because it would have raised funds to contribute to her album and so many things she wanted to do. But she was very adamant that she would go the distance and she's gonna make it happen with or without tickets. So I must say to WAC Radio, who's also from San Fernando, a gentleman by the name of Kenny Phillips, who is well known in the industry. He's a bit troublesome, he doesn't give trouble, but he's one of the most talented, gifted men of the soil. He's developing a dynasty for himself, but not for him. His children are doing really well in Los Angeles and right here in Trinidad and Tobago. So I would tell the world, I would tell them, can he give trouble? But he's a great one in Jesus' name. I love him like that. So there's a lot happening. So the show is taking place on the 31st of December. Oh my God, I see since December we're working on this thing. On the 31st of May, it's going to be done from WAC Radio station on the platform there. We now have Synergy has joined us to show us live, to show Sherma's concert live. We have Temple Networks, Dr. Frederick Morton is here in Trinidad because of the pandemic. And he's going to beam this out to 4.5 million viewership in the Caribbean. His partner with us to make it possible. TTT has been calling me while I'm here with the mayor. I hope TTT is coming on board to show this live. So right now we have Gaia, we have WAC Radio, we have Temple Networks, we have Synergy with the kindness live. So we're asking the people to contribute, to donate, so that we can do more. There's another big concert we're gonna launch from Trinidad to the world. It's being planned to be beamed to Africa, to Canada, to the United States, to London, to France, and Germany, right here from Trinidad. It's gonna be taking place on Father's Day. So we look out for that, you know. So basically, that's some of the insight that was going on. If you give me your information, I would give you a little more to that you can that, speak about.
That May
30th
concert, that's the launch of the album?
No. This album, has nothing to do with the launch of the album. We're now finalizing the first single vocal piece today. So when we leave here, Sherma is going straight to the studio to work on those.
You
want to
tell us what studio you're recording from?
Well, actually, right now it's a private studio, but we're recording with Mr. Dingwall.
Okay.
Yes.
So,
have you talked about?
Let me contribute to that. We are not doing the full recording. The product is being produced in Canada.
Okay.
The vocal takes are being done here with Mr. Dingwall.
Mm-hmm. And in Canada by Trinidad.
Yes. so we are as I said earlier, we're taking the top. The person who is working with Sherma as the person who worked with New Creation to take them to number 3 in Europe. So we're taking the top players in the industry to work with Sherma. Yes?
That's what I wanted to talk to you about. You talked about the inroads that you would have made and you would have blazed a trail with New Creation and the eyes of the world on us at that point in time. Is there any kind of collaboration now with the Ministry of Tourism in terms of what to do in the
show? Well, you know, my arms are open.
Mm-hmm.
I'm open. I would like to meet, I would put a call out for the Minister of Culture and Tourism, the Honorable Minister. I understand he's from Coquille Village. He's from South San Fernando. He's here. We haven't reached out to him as yet. This is our very first meeting with an official, a government official. And it is the mayor of San Fernando. I do believe the mayor will guide us in the right direction, how we could get the support to give we need to hold hands, right, to make this happen. But we definitely will be interested in collaboration, collaborating with the Ministry of Culture, Ministry of Tourism, and other ministries and the private sector. And that first could begin through these donations, but at a bigger level, that partnership is where we're looking to go. Yes,
So the concert, is it you in concert or do you have other guest artists?
We have other guest artists.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I am in concert, but we have wonderful artists. We have Pastor Baines, Terrence Baines from Tobago. We have Destiny Charles. She's a young and upcoming. We have Bonnet Bickford. You know, she's a sweet, wonderful, gifted artist.
La Brigue.
As you all know.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. She's, you know her very well.
Yes,
right?
Yes, yes.
Last but not least, we have Darren Shepard, my dear friend.
Pleasantville in the house.
Yes, absolutely. And so we're going to have a wonderful time. It's a time to really, you know, help people through this hard time and, you know, comfort and, you know, get them a little diverted and enjoy something for a change. You know, they're going to be home and we're going to adhere to strict protocol, COVID protocol on stage. So we're not going to break any rules here. But we're going to have
the studio with
yes, it's going to be virtually, at WAC, it's going to be nice and virtual. But we're going to try to touch some hearts and make everybody feel good.
Do you know Randolph Jeffers?
He said
you used to come to his home studio with some folks from Pleasantville.
And where is he?
He's online right now on Facebook.
Really?
Mm-hmm. He's hearing you.
Hi, Randall. Well, you know what? Maybe I'm escaping the moments, but I'm sure if we talk, I'll definitely remember.
He's an accountant. He was in England with me studying.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Right. Shall
we wish
you
all the best? I would have seen you in concert many years ago at Nakumo Hollis.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yeah.
That means a lot to me. That
concert
was the start of so much.
Let me thank Mr. Ravi for giving us a overall perspective of where he wants to go and where he sees Shunagoya and very excited about it as well, and it's happy to promote daughter of the subject. Shubha, congratulations in advance for all you have done and all you're going to do. And look forward to working with you and helping with all we can. Sando City Corporation in your office is open to you. And you feel free to call and whatever we can do. So we're looking forward to great things from you. Congratulations.
Thank you so much for seeing us. Thank you.
The guy say you know him as Randy. His full name is Jeffers, Randolph Jeffers. But he says that your name is Randy.
Yes, absolutely, I know Randy. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Yes. Hi, Randy. Yeah, we had some good times. I remember, doing some recordings with my friend.
Is it on here?
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Can
you
hand it
to
me? Okay, can you just get it? Sure. You know, it's a good company.
Okay. I look for this, I'm going to enjoy. I know
thank you so much.
This is just from my hero.
Oh, that's wonderful.
My time.
Wonderful, yeah. Thank you.
I got a kick.
Yes.
Jazz, like that.
Yes.
So I see my children probably said that you do not get the time, but this is what it's quality was.
It's so much quality.
Yeah.
It was a beautiful time.
Substance of the music of. I struggle with even modern music. I struggle to listen to the lyrics.
Yes. It's an emptiness that's going on right now that is very sad. A lot of emptiness.
But listen, I have been listening to 70s soul and a whole lot of old music that I know with you. I've been listening to this guy,
Michael Bublé.
I've just been listening to Brompton.
And Sam Cooke.
I think it's music that you can sing along to because all this new music, I can't sing. I don't know what they're singing. I can whistle, but I can't sing with it. I don't know the
lyrics. Well, if you want to make a just take close off. You see them?
So
I was looking at the one of those shows, was it the DT? I think it was some time ago on television. It was a BT award show.
Mm-hmm.
And they were literally singing vegan.
Yeah.
That's what you have to do to be good,
to
be good.
It's sad, right? It's very sad.
It is.
It is.
They need some Jesus.
They really do. And it's really sad because there's an emptiness in the culture. They believe, they actually enjoy the emptiness. They're not trying to get more like substance out of anything. I spoke to my daughter and she actually told me that. She said that.
You didn't ask him to make a personal life.
That's all right. That's good. That's good. But she was telling me
that's a good question. Because mothers are so important, of course fathers too. But Sherma's daughter just top university in highest honors 3 weeks ago.
What did she do?
Psychology.
Mm-hmm. Why would she have studied? At
St. Elizabeth University.
Your only daughter?
That's right, my older daughter.
Mm-hmm.
I have a younger one as well. I have a 14-year-old.
Mm-hmm.
And she's the one who's telling me as well. The way, you know, the culture is today and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, my older daughter is very smart. She's always like getting a 4.0 every semester. I don't know. She's just incredible and I learned so much from her. It's a lovely thing to have a child that you're learning from and having that nice warm interaction. She's
22. Mm-hmm. So we have the names?
I'm sorry?
Names.
Naya Marie.
N-I-A-H.
Mm-hmm. Marie.
Mm-hmm.
And my little one, my 14-year-old, is Taylor over here.
Taylor?
Yes.
T-A-Y-L-Y.
T-A-Y-L-Y. Mm-hmm. Sweet, sweet, very sweet.
So two things you did. You put God first and you follow your dream.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
The message.
You
put God first and follow your dream.
Could you tell us some of the artists you've been listening to while growing up that have inspired you?
Oh, wow, that's a nice question.
Yeah.
I love, well, of course, and you know I love Whitney Houston, Stevie Wonder, Sting, Chris Stanley. David Runner. Alex Farah too. You know, Farah is very influential. Billy Ocean. There's a good few. There's Billy Joel, Sting, Nancy Wilson, Ella Fitzgerald, the legendary lady singers that I
when you call the names, I remember the songs. You do me, do me,
do
me, do me, do me, do me, do me, do
me,
do me, do me,
That means time to go.
No, that means we have to take care of them. That's
so
all.
But just put a big number there, you know. I don't know, looking at it differently, you know. I'm a man of the arts.
Yeah, no. Well, we have to have
them there
singing some more.
No, I'm
singing. Nice little jazz.
So I think that we should do something. I just come in
to wish you well and be there to give you some thumbs up and things.
Regrello, because it's all about them.